Hello everyone, hope you all are doing fine. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do input handling so we can handle keyboard and mouse events. Okay, let's start. First of all, let's start with the keyboard. I'm going to create a C++ class for the keyboard. Okay, first I'm going to create an interface for the key event handler. So if you are interested in key events, we can extend our class to this interface and it will receive key events. In this interface you have two functions. First one is onKeyPressed function and the second is onKeyReleased function. So when a key is pressed, onKeyPressed function will get called, and the key is released, onKeyReleased function will get called. And then we can go to the keyboard class. So in this class, you have two functions for register and unregister key event handlers. And we have isKeyDown function to check whether the key is down or pressed, and isKeyUp function to check whether key is released. And also there are two private functions to inject key events into this keyboard class. One is injectKeyPressed function and the other is injectKeyReleased function. Also, we have a vector to hold our registered key event handlers. Okay, let's go to the implementation of these functions. Okay, let's start by implementing isKeyDown function. Here we call SDL getKeyboardState function and we return the status of the given key. isKeyUp function is also the same as the isKeyDown function, but we add not operator to the return value to invert the key status. Then we have register key event handler function. Here we add the given handler to the vector if it is not already registered. Inside the unregister function, we simply remove the handler if it is already added. In the inject key down function, we iterate through all the handlers and call on key pressed function. InjectKeyRelease function also the same, but we call onKeyReleased function instead of onKeyPressed. Okay, that's all for the keyboard class. Okay, now I am going to create a class for the mouse. First of all, I am going to create an interface for mouse event handlers. In this interface, we have three functions. One is onMouseButtonPressed. The second is on mouse button released and the third is on mouse move. Now let's go to the mouse class. Here we have two functions for register and unregister event handlers. Then we have isMouseButtonDown function and isMouseButtonUp function. And then we have getMousePosition function. And then we have three private functions to inject mouse events. Also, we have a vector to hold registered mouse event handlers. Okay, now we can implement these functions. So let's open the CPP file. First of all, in the register function, we need to add handler to our vector. And in the unregister function, we remove the handler from our vector. Then inside isMouseButtonDown function, we call SDL getMouseState function and check the flag for buttonDownState. And of course, we need to include SDL header file, and the algorithm header file is also needed for the vector operations. Okay, isMouseButtonUp function is also the same, but we return false if the button is down. Then inside getMousePosition function, we call SDL getMouseState function by giving x and y integer pointers. And then inside inject functions, we simply iterate all the mouse event handlers and call relevant functions. Okay, that's all for the mouse class. Okay, now we have completed our input handlers. Now we need to inject events to these objects. So let's do it. Let's go to 3drenderer.cpp file, and inside the game loop, I am going to introduce a new function to process events. And it is the function that responsible for injecting events into our keyboard and mouse objects. Okay, let's start by creating the function. I call it handleInput, and it takes keyboard and mouse objects as arguments. Okay, inside this function, we check for mouse and keyboard events from the SDL library, and then we inject them into our keyboard and mouse objects. Okay, now I am going to cut the event processing code inside our game loop and paste it here. Okay, in the switch block, I am interested in SDL key down, SDL key up, and mouse button down, mouse button up, and mouse motion events. Then we should call inject functions accordingly inside each case. Okay, since our inject functions are private, we have to define this handle input function as a friend function to the keyboard and mouse. Okay, let's do that. Copy the function signature and paste it in the keyboard class. I do the same for the mouse class. And I have to forward declare keyboard and mouse classes because I can't include those header files in this files because then we will have circular dependency. Okay, it's done, and let's go back to the handle input function. Okay, that's all for the handle input function. Now let's create the keyboard and mouse objects. Okay, then we need to call the handle input function inside the game loop. Okay, now our input handling mechanism is ready, and now we can test it. So let's try to move our cube object using WASD keys. First of all, I remove the code that rotates the cube. And then I remove the model matrix away from the game loop, so it will not reset the position in every iteration. Now we can use our keyboard class functions. So if the W key is down, I move the cube in negative Z direction, which is forward. And if the S key is down, I move the cube in opposite direction. So the cube will move to the backward direction. Likewise, if the A key is down, I move the cube in negative X direction. And if the D key is down, I move the cube in positive X direction. Okay, now let's try to run it. As you can see, we can move our cube object using keyboard. In the next video, we will create a camera controller using this input handling mechanism. And thanks for watching.